You know, it's funny because as a writer, I worked in the house, which was a great asset. I was at home, and I used to work until the children came from school. At the point, I used to put my foot down and, you know, give them the tea and spend time with them. We used to play because in those days there was no TV. So we used to play carom and they used to go out to play, etc. So there's no problem at that time of, you know, any kind of conflict between the family. My son one day told me that, oh, you think there was no problem, but whenever I used to come home, I used to come home very gently so as not to disturb you. I don't remember that. So perceptions are so different. Maybe, but on the whole, I think because I worked at home, the problems were less. Problems used to come when I had invitations to go out of the country. Or even in the country, lectures, seminars, conferences. I mean, I got a huge number of invitations in the 90s and early, you know, after 2000. So leaving the house and going was very hard on me. And my husband had bad health problem. So to leave him and go. And then I remember when I first went to England, I had Virago invited me. My younger son just joined Pondicherry Medical College and he came back out of holiday and he said, oh, I come home and you go away. You know, that kind of thing made me feel very bad. So there is always a conflict, but I think each one solves it in her or his own way. I don't think one can make a general rule about these things. I think both are important. But as small children are concerned, I believe that they need all the time, all the care you can give them. You write late at night or, you know, you write early morning or whatever. So there's a lot of compromises to be done. There's a lot of kind of trying to fit in everybody's, you know, this is what my first novel, not my third novel, which became, got the Academy Award, it came out of that. That I had to fit in into everybody else's time into my, this thing. Nobody took my schedule as important, you know, that kind. And I was writing like, I mean, I really had a hard time writing that novel. My husband had just started in his practice, given up his job, we had moved house many times. Then I used to, for one whole year, I did the typing of reports for him. So I had to learn all those difficult medical words. Then my father was very sick, then he died. And, you know, it's sort of endless. And my elder son went to Bombay. So, you know, he was in that stage. And then the younger son had to go. He was doing his second PU and he wanted complete quiet in the house. Nobody talked, nobody to do anything. You know, even my pen scratching would disturb him, I think. So I wrote it out of such a lot of problems. For me, that sort of typified all the problems you have, even if you're sitting at home and writing. You know, nothing came easy. The maid would come, the dhobi would come. I was never undisturbed. Nobody ever said, she's working, let's not disturb her. Whereas when my father was working, my mother stood guard. You know, nobody could disturb him. And I had to deal with everything. And my husband was just practicing. He was out all day, morning to night. So, you know, I didn't have his support also at that time. It was hard. It was extremely hard. So as the time went on and the children got married and left home, it became easier.